Hey, my name is Matt Johnson, and today I want to show you how to export extremely high-quality 4K videos for YouTube, Vimeo, Facebook, etc. using Adobe Premiere Pro. And to save you time, I've actually created a set of free export presets that you can download at the link below and give you all of these high-quality 4K export settings immediately without you needing to dial everything in manually. They even come with instructions showing you how to import them into Premiere Pro. So, go download them for free down below. Moving on, let's open up Premiere Pro now. And as you can see, I have already created a project with a 4K 24 frames per second video clip that I've imported and edited on the timeline. And let's pretend that this is a full video that I've already edited and I'm ready to export. Once you reach this point, you can either press Control M on PC or Command M on a Mac, or you can go up here to this new Export tab that was added in the 2022 version of Premiere Pro. If you do not see this export tab, that means you're probably on an earlier version of Premiere and your export setup will look different than how it looks here. But the good news is that I actually have another video that you can watch for exporting in the previous version of Premiere Pro, and I will link to that video in the corner and down in the video description if you want to watch that. With the export settings open now, make sure that next to Media File, this little blue toggle is enabled, and then on the right, you can name your video file. Let's call this My 4K Video, and then click on Location and select where you want to save your video file to. This is very important because if you do not choose a location, then you're not going to know where your rendered video file is going to end up. So definitely make sure that you choose a place that you will remember and you will be able to find. With that done, next go down here to Preset. And you're going to want to select the high quality 2160p 4K preset. And then here for format, instead of leaving it set to H.264, you're gonna wanna click this dropdown and select HEVC H.265, because this is the newest video format that's gonna give you the highest video quality. At this point, you're probably thinking, this is great, Matt. Now I just go down here and hit export in the bottom right corner and I'm ready to go. No, because remember, I told you at the start of this video that I want to give you the best possible export settings. And by default, Adobe's not going to give you the best. So this means that we're going to need to dig into these video settings. Now, I already have the video tab open here, but if yours looks like this, click on this video tab, and then you're going to see all the settings like I have. Hold on to your beard for a bit. Things are going to get a bit complicated, but trust me, this is really important, and I'm going to walk you through it all and make it easy. Starting off, for frame size, you're going to want to make sure that UHD 3840 by 2160 is selected. If your settings are grayed out here and this is different, you can click any of these checkboxes to enable you to change these settings. For frame rate, make sure it's set to 23.976, and for aspect, make sure it's set to square pixels 1.0. Next, if you do not see these other settings, you can click the More button here and that will enable them. And you're going to want to make sure that Render Maximum Depth is checked and Use Maximum Render Quality is checked. I mean, this is going to help enhance the quality of your video file, and you definitely want the highest quality video, which is why you're watching this video. Next, under encoding settings, for performance, you're going to want to make sure that hardware encoding is selected. If that is not available and you can only select software encoding, that's okay. But by selecting hardware encoding, this is going to enable you to render your videos dramatically faster because Premiere is going to use your computer's graphics card. So I highly recommend having hardware encoding selected if it is available. Next, for profile, make sure it is set to main. If you click here, you can see that you also have the option for main 10, but main 10 requires you to use a HDR exporting workflow, which is a lot more complicated, and for 99.9% of people, you're just gonna wanna select main and things are gonna look great. For level, leave it at 5.1, but for tier, you're gonna wanna change this from main to high, which is going to unlock your bitrate so you can export in even higher quality. Lastly, for HDR graphics white nits, leave this set to 100. If this is set to something else, set it to 100. Moving on down to bitrate settings now. This is the biggest and most important setting that is going to affect the quality of your videos the most when you're exporting. If you want the highest possible video quality, for bitrate encoding, you're going to want to select CBR, which stands for constant bitrate, which means the Premiere is always going to be telling your video to be as high quality as possible. If you are uploading to YouTube or another website online and you want to guarantee the highest possible video quality, set your target bitrate to 50. In the past, if you were using the older H.264 video codec, I would have recommended exporting at 100 megabits per second. But because we are now using the HEVC H.265 codec, it is a much more efficient and newer codec, meaning you can actually export it at half that bitrate by setting it to 50. This is gonna result in a reasonably large video file here. As you can see under this estimated file size section, this is telling me this video clip's gonna be 16 megabytes and it's only a few seconds long. So you can get an idea of how big this size is going to be. But trust me, this bigger video size is going to be completely worth it if you want the highest quality 4K video whenever you upload to YouTube or anywhere else. Incidentally, speaking of the highest quality videos on YouTube, even if you did not film your video in 4K and you filmed it in 1080p, for example, I would still recommend using these 4K export settings for basically everything if you're uploading your video to YouTube. Because if you upscale your lower resolution video files to 4K and then upload them to YouTube, YouTube is going to use a significantly higher bitrate whenever it's playing your video back, and the quality will be dramatically better than if you had uploaded it in HD. So in short, always upload to YouTube in 4K. And you can do that for pretty much any other site either, Facebook or Vimeo, etc. It will pretty much always help you to upload in 4K. Lastly, keep in mind that this 50 megabits per second is just the bitrate that I recommend if you are exporting at 24 frames per second. If you are exporting at a higher frame rate of 30 frames per second, then in that case, I would recommend exporting at a higher bitrate of 60 megabits per second. And for 60 FPS footage, I would export at 120 megabits per second. Basically, whatever your frame rate is, your bitrate should be double that number and you're good. Shout out to Casey Ferris for that way of thinking about bitrates. It's really easy to remember and I will link to his channel down below. With that, make sure that for quality, highest, slowest is selected, and those are all your video settings. Next, go down to the audio tab and make sure that for audio format, AAC is selected, audio codec AAC, sample rate 48,000 Hz, channel stereo, and bitrate 320 kilobits per second. This should already all be selected by default, but it doesn't hurt to check. And congratulations, your video settings are all done and you are about ready to export your video. But if you want to save time and avoid having to dial in all these settings in the future every single time you export a video, you now have two options. First, you can download my free presets that will give you all of these settings that we just covered and enable you to use them as a preset every single time you export your video. These presets are available for free download at the link down below. Or you can actually create your own preset by saving all the settings that we just put together as a preset of your own. To do that, go up here to the preset drop-down menu and click these three dots to the right of it, and then click Save Preset. And let's call this H.265, 4K, 24 FPS, 50 Mbps, who is Matt? There we go, and press OK. Then, anytime you want to export your video using these settings, you can go here to this preset drop-down, select this H.265, etc. preset, and then go down here and either select Send to Media Encoder or Export, and your video is done. That's it. Thank you so much for watching this video all about how to export high quality HD videos in Premiere Pro. Can I help you out even more though? I've put together a free guide called Edit Videos Like a Pro, and this guide is gonna walk you through some of my biggest tips as a video editor. These things took me years to learn, but you can use this guide to take a huge shortcut. You can download the guide completely for free at the link down below. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.